Hello students, welcome to my channel Engineers Academy. Kindly subscribe my channel for the solution of such problems. Now we are given this problem. In this problem it is said that a nuclear reactor vessel has a weight of this much, 500 into 10 to the power 3 pounds, and we are required to determine the horizontal compressive force that the spreader bar AB exerts on point A, right? So this problem has two parts. So first we need to find the force exerted by this AB spreader bar, which separates this AD and this BE cable from each other, right? So this is the spreader bar. So we need to find the force that is applied by this spreader bar at this point A, and it is said that it determines the horizontal compressive force, right? So this means that this AB spreader is under compression. Whenever a particular component is under compression, so its length will decrease, right? So this means that this spreader bar is having the forces in this direction, right? So the forces are applied on this spreader bar in this direction, and they are compressing this spreader bar, right? So this means that the length of this spreader bar will tend to decrease, right? So this means that as a reaction, this spreader bar will apply the opposite force on at this point A, right? So this means that the reaction force of this spreader bar at this point A will be in the opposite direction, right? So this will be the force applied by the spreader bar at this point A, right? And so we will find this force, right? So let's say that this reaction force applied by this spreader bar at this point A is, let's say, TAB. Let's say that that force is TAB, right? So we have to find that force. So let me draw the free body diagram, right? So we will have TAB in this direction. First, let's say that this is our positive x and y direction, right? So this will be the tension AB, which will be acting in this direction, right? Or the compressive force, right? So let's say this is force AB, let's say. That is the force applied by this spreader bar at this point A. And this AC rope will be in tension, right? So this will, we will have a force in this direction, right? And this force is, let's say, TAC, and it is making 30 degrees with the horizontal. This is given, right? And similarly, we will have one tension AD, right? So we can write that we will have this tension AD, which will be acting vertically downward, right? So this is our tension TAD. So let's say that this is our positive x and this is our positive y direction. So now if we look into this free body diagram, so then this TAC is unknown, this FAB is unknown, and this TAD is unknown, right? So in these three forces, at least we require to have one known force, right? So then we will be able to find the other two forces. So this means that we cannot solve this problem by using this free body diagram. So then we will consider this point C. So if we consider this point C, so as we can see that the tension in this portion of this system or this pulley, so we can say that this pulley will support the whole weight of this nuclear reactor, right? So if we draw the forces at this point C, so then we will have a force in this direction, tension in this direction, and this tension, let's say that this will be equal to the weight of the nuclear reactor. So we can say that this will be equal to the weight, and weight will be how much? So this will be 500 into 10 raised to the power 3, right? And similarly, there will be a tension AC at this point, and the direction of that tension will be acting away from this point C, right? So we can write that we will have tension AC in this direction, right? And there will be another tension BC, and that will be acting in this direction, right? So now from this we can find this TAC. So let me convert this into free body diagram. Now this is our free body diagram, and if we draw the positive x and y axis is. So we can write like this. So this, let's say this is my positive x and this is my positive y direction. So as we can see that this is our TBC force and this is our TAC, right? So this TAC and TBC are having 30 degrees with the horizontal. This is 30 degrees and this angle is 30 degrees. So if this is 30 degrees, so then this is also 30 degrees. And similarly, if this is 30, so then this is also 30 degrees. So, and this is that point C, right? This is that point C. Now, if we apply the equilibrium condition at this point C, right, and in this free body diagram, this is our point A, right? So, if we apply the equilibrium condition at this point C, so let's say that if we apply the summation of forces along y equal to 0 at this point, so for that we will resolve these forces into its components, right? So then if we resolve these two forces, so this TBC will have one component in this direction and it will have one component in this direction, and similarly this TAC will have one component in this direction and it will have one component in this direction, right? So now if we apply the summation of forces along y equals to 0, so then this weight is acting in the positive y direction, so we will write 500 into 10 raised to the power 3 and this is positive. And this component is acting in the negative y direction, so this is TBC sine of 30, right? So we can write that minus TBC sine of 30 degrees. And similarly, this is TAC sine of 30 degrees, right? So we can say that this is minus TAC sine of 30 degrees and this will be equal to 0. And now if we apply the summation of forces along x equals to 0, let me write it here, the summation of forces along x equals to 0. So now as we can see that this is the cos component, right? So this is TBC cos of 30 degrees and this is TAC cos component, right? So this is plus, this one is minus, right? So we will write minus TAC cos of 30 degrees and this will be equal to 0. And if we bring this to the other side of the equation, so this will be equal, right? And cos of 30 and cos of 30 will cancel out, so we will be left with TBC equals to TAC, right? So if we substitute the result of this condition into this equation, so then we can see that TBC is equal to TAC. So we can write that TBC, we can replace this TBC with TAC. So then we can write that this equation will be 500 into 10 raised to the power 3 minus 2TAC sine of 30 degrees and this will be equal to 0. And if we bring this to the other side of equation, so this will become positive and TAC will be equal to 500 into 10 raised to the power 3 divided by 2 sine of 30 degrees. So TAC comes out to be equal to 500 into 10 raised to the power 3 pounds, right? So sine of 30 is 1 divided by 2, so this 2 will cancel out, so we will be left with this value, right? So this means that TBC is equal to TAC and this is equal to 500 into 10 raised to the power 3 pounds, right? So now we can find these two forces FAB and TAD, since we know this TAC. So TAC is 500 into 10 raised to the power 3 pounds. Now to find these two forces FAB and TAD, we will apply the equilibrium condition at this point A. So now if we write that the summation of forces along x equals to 0 at this point A, right? So this is the solution for this free body diagram, right? So again we will resolve these forces into its components, right? So this TAC will have two components. It will have one component in this direction, right? And it will have one component in this direction. So this one will be the cos component, right? So this will be TAC cos of 30 degrees, right? So this will be TAC cos of 30 degrees and TAC is 500 into 10 raised to the power 3, right? So we can write that this FAB is acting in the negative x direction. So we will write minus FAB plus this component TAC cos of 30, and TAC is 500 into 10 raised to the power 3 cos of 30 degrees, and this will be equal to 0. So this gives us FAB equals to 433 into 10 raised to the power 3 pounds, right? So this is the force exerted by the spreader bar at this point A, right? And now if we apply the summation of forces along y equals to 0, so then we have this component, which is the sine component. This is 500 into 10 raised to the power 3 sine of 30 degrees, right? So we can write that this TAD is acting in the negative y direction, so I will write minus TAD, and this is acting in the positive y direction, so we will write plus 500 into 10 raised to the power 3 sine of 30 degrees equals to 0, and we can say that TAD equals to, this is minus, so this will become minus 500 into 10 raised to the power 3 sine of 30 degrees, minus will cancel out. From this equation TAD, we get TAD, which is equal to 250 into 10 raised to the power 3 pounds, right? So these are the two forces which are exerted at this point A, right? So this is the solution of this particular problem.